Okay, let's take a look at how to diagram a positives. First of all, we should know that a positives are nouns or noun phrases that give us more information about another noun or pronoun. So, for instance, in these two sentences, we could find the positives. First, my sister Josephine is a gourmet cook. So sister would be the subject here, but which sister? Josephine serves as the appositive. You'll notice that Josephine is a proper noun and it's modifying the noun sister. In the second example, my sister, a gourmet cook, prepared escargot. Here we see a non-essential appositive because it's set off by commas, which means it could be removed and the sentence will still make perfect sense. My sister, a gourmet cook, prepared escargot. So a gourmet cook is the appositive phrase in this case. Cook is the appositive noun, and it is modify sister. So let's take a look at how to diagram these. Here's the first sentence. My sister, Josephine, is a gourmet cook. You'll notice that sister is the subject, is the linking verb, and she is a cook. What kind of cook? A gourmet cook. Josephine here is the appositive, and we set it off in parentheses right next to the noun. So wherever the appositive belongs, that's where the appositive will go in the diagram. Look at the other sentence. My sister, a gourmet cook, prepared escargot. Okay, so a gourmet cook is the appositive phrase. It's modifying or giving us more information about the noun sister. You'll notice when you have an appositive phrase, look for the noun, which is the main part, and it goes in parentheses next to the noun it is modifying. What kind of cook? A cook. What kind exactly? A gourmet cook. And you'll notice that these two adjectives go underneath the appositive noun in parentheses. Before we move on to practice, let's look at one more type of appositive called an emphatic appositive, also known as the intensive pronoun. So here's two examples. I made the coffee myself, and the teachers themselves were unsure. So you'll notice that myself is the intensive pronoun or the emphatic appositive because it adds emphasis to I, but doesn't really do anything else. It doesn't really do much work in the sentence. The same goes for themselves in the second sentence. Teachers themselves were unsure. Themselves does not change or add any additional meaning, but it does give emphasis to the teachers. Here is how you diagram. You'll see that it diagrams the same way as our previous two examples. And now here's your chance to try it out. You have five sentences here. Be careful. Take your time. Good luck and enjoy. Let's look at our first two answers together. Your friend John is the man for the job. Okay, so friend is the main subject. John is the appositive that tells us more about friend. So which friend? Your friend John. John is the man for the job. So we have a linking verb. We have man is the predicate noun. And then some more information about the man. Let's contrast this with number two. We need your friend John. Okay, so John, once again, is an appositive that's giving us more information or more detail about the friend. But in this case, friend is serving as the direct object of the sentence. So this is just to show that the appositive can really be placed anywhere a noun or pronoun is. So you can expect to find appositives at different locations in a sentence. And here at number three, we have another one that's kind of here just as a chance to trick you. Did you fall for the trick? So, John, we need to ask your friend. John, in this case, is serving as the noun of direct address. And like an interjection, it sits on its own horizontal line above the diagram. Just as a refresher, we is the subject, need is the verb, and the direct object has an infinitive phrase to ask. Ask whom? To ask your friend. So friend is the direct object of the infinitive phrase. Altogether, that's serving as the direct object of the sentence. And number four, do you remember John, our friend from Rhode Island? And in this case, you'll see that friend, not John, is in parentheses. This friend is part of the appositive phrase that modifies John. Do you remember subject and verb? Do you remember whom? John is the direct object. Our friend from Rhode Island is the appositive phrase. Good job with this. I predict you got it right. And then lastly, number five. And as you may have guessed, number five has two opportunities to diagram an appositive. First, an intensive appositive that adds emphasis to John. John himself took the bus, his best option of affordable transportation. So John took what? He took the bus. Bus is the direct object. And then his best option of affordable transportation is the appositive phrase. The noun here in that phrase is option. And you'll notice that you don't want to use transportation, which you might have done. Transportation is part of a prepositional phrase of transportation. So although it's a noun, it's the object of the preposition, and therefore it wouldn't function, would not function as an appositive in this case. Okay, I hope you did well with that. And now you know how to diagram appositives.